डिक्टेशन नंबर 15, स्पीड 18 वर्ड्स पर मिनट। स्टार्ट। इन द व्यू ऑफ द नंबर प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ आवर कंट्री, यूनिवर्सिटी हैव वेरी वाइटल एंड सिग्निफिकेंट रोल टू प्ले। द रियल प्रॉस्पेरिटी ऑफ अ country depends not on the abundance of its, not a struggle of its, not on the beauty of its public buildings, but it consistent in its seeds of learning in the citizens, in its main of education, enlightenment and character. It is the scholar and thinker, not the soldiers, that make mar the density of a country, density of a nation. Remarks is founded with the budding youth, as is the flower within the close of the petals. That what our youths think today, the nation will think tomorrow. Again, the famous saying of Jesus comes to our mind. Give me the children of the country, I will not about what happened to the rest. So long we are able to impart a good education to our children in schools and colleges, we need not despair of bright future of our country. The social of national reconstruction of our country on the sound and permanent basic purpose, deep thinking and planning on the part of our national leader and administrators, without a right type of education, our youths cannot make such leaders of thought that are capable of looking at things in their proper and guiding the people on the highway of progress and prosperity. The fundamental objective of our university education is to produce skilled and highly qualified men in the country. We have to presume that objective with a purpose, walking with aimless feet is bound to lead us in winter. There must be vision for which we inspire. It is a good for which we strive. Needs more scientists, technology, mathematicians, inventors and characters. During last 16 years, we have not produced any scientific or an inventor except depend on other. Even Dictation number 51, speed 100 words per minute. Start. The book I like most is It is short novel written by George Eliot. It is very interesting novel with a simple but powerful story. The story has been narrated in an excellent manner. I found it absorbing and I have read quite a number of good novels, but somehow has impressed me no other book of fiction has done. It is a story of a poor, lean weaver, Silas Miner. He was a simple young man and lived in Lantern Yard. He lived by honest hard work and performed his religious duties with great devotion. He had a close friend, William Dane. He was engaged to a girl named Sarah. He was happy and contented for all he needed, but his happiness was short-lived. His friend Dan fell in love with Sarah. He accused Manor of thief. People in those days believed that by drawing lots that could find out the truth. They drew lots. In fact, he had not anything. It was Dan who had involved him in this case, and he believed in just God. Now he thought that God was not just in this grief. He left Lantern Yard. He went to a village and settled there. There he worked hard at his, and 15 years he a lot of gold coins. He did not like to mix with people and hurt his fellow beings, because William Dane had better him. He carried only for God. There was no other interest in his life. He had banished love, friendship, and kindness from his heart. One night, his gold was set alone. He was made with grief. Now he had nothing to live for. His heart was broken. A few days after, he found a golden little girl. No one claimed her, so Manor adopted her. Manor named her after his dead sister. The girl